this is another meeting. This one's happening at Nitish Kumar's Delhi residence. The Bihar Chief Minister arriving and meeting with key JDU leaders. We'll just tell you a little bit more about who these leaders are. But remember, why is this important? Right now, the ask, the big ask that will come forward from the JDU and from the TDP, that is awaited. We know what's been hinted at. Both JDU and TDP have said they want several key plum portfolios. We heard a little earlier from sources within the JDU that were saying they want to ask for three portfolios. Railway is right at the top, but they also want to ask for agriculture and finance. At the same time, we know the TDP has hinted at similar. The JDS has also hinted at similar. So all of the BJP's NDA allies seemingly attempting to go for some key portfolios there. Now, what will the BJP give in to? Where will the BJP concede? That's obviously the big question. What is their navigational, their stance right now? That's going to be interesting to see how they negotiate this. We'll just take you to these visuals that are coming in right now. Key leaders of the JDU right now arriving at Nitish Kumar's residence. I just want to take you to some of the names we're seeing arriving right now. Our reporters also telling us that you have Sanjay Jha, Kiru Mato is there, for example, Alok Kumar Suman. You have a number of other leaders, Harshvardhan Singh, Mahabali Singh. Let's just go over to our colleague Arunima to understand more. Arunima, over the next few hours, each movement of both Nitish Kumar and Chandrababu Naidu and their party leaders will be studied. Right now, we're seeing the JDU's leaders arrive at Nitish Kumar's residence. As that big question, what will the JDU settle for? What will the BJP give them? That remains up in the air. Can you just tell us more about this meeting?
Yes, these are all JDU legislators one by one coming to Delhi and coming to this residence which Nitish Kumar uses when he is in Delhi. Since yesterday, we have seen Lalan Singh, Sanjay Jha, the national president of JDU is Lalan Singh. Sanjay Jha is a member of Rajya Sabha, very close confidant of Nitish Kumar. They were here before the NDA alliance meeting took place. And today, since morning, for MLCs in Bihar, former MPs, former MLAs and also MP-elects, current treasurers of the party, so party functionaries as well as party legislators, they're all coming to Nitish Kumar's residence since morning in trying to ascertain as to what is the next course of action that the party should have. When we ask some of them whether in terms of ministries there is any consensus. Okay, and there are more leaders now coming in. Chintan is just going to pan you and show how there are more JDU netas who are walking into Nitish Kumar's residence. More vehicles carrying legislators coming in here. We'll try and get you a sense from them about what really is on the agenda. But essentially, these meetings are to firm up the sense that JDU has about their participation in the government. Let me see if I can get in a word from the gentleman here. Sir, JDU keh rahe hai sarkar ko kyun join karne wali hai, mantralay ko lekar kuch tay hua hai. Okay, not wanting to comment, just leaving it to Nitish Kumar at the moment. These are JDU legislators who are leaving it to Nitish Kumar, but at the same time letting Nitish Kumar know their minds. We are told there is a caste balancing act also going on between Kushwahas, upper caste and the extremely backward caste. So whoever makes it to the cabinet or makes it to the Union Council of Minister from JDU will have to ensure that the caste balance is also properly maintained along with the development goals.
Arunima, thank you for telling us a little bit more about what lies at stake right now. Now, as JDU leaders arrive, can you just tell our audiences, Arunima, because we've been discussing the possible names, as you just told us, that the JDU is looking at for these key ministerial posts. But in their heads, how many seats or plum portfolios could they be looking at? Because we know the TDP is also looking to ask for two. How do these different alliance partners actually navigate with each other's demands?
See, 2 to 3 is what we are told by the JDU also, and they have 12 members of parliament. Last time they had about 16 and only one cabinet minister. But this time the 12 MPs of JDU are much more important to the survival of the central government, and therefore they are trying to bargain hard. At least 3 positions in the Union Council, one could be MOS, 2 could be cabinet. If all goes well, they would actually push for 3 cabinet rank as well. What they're essentially saying is that Bihar assembly elections are due, and Nitish Kumar has made some promises to people of Bihar in these general elections. Tejaswi Yadav is gaining this perception that he's a young leader willing to provide an alternative to Bihar. So to counter that perception, Nitish Kumar needs the Bharatiya Janata Party to support him. And therefore, portfolios like rural development, like agriculture, like railways, are something that the JDU could push hard for. Like I said, at least two cabinet, maybe one MOS is what they would bargain.
Okay, thank you for bringing us that context. We're just going to move on very quickly right now.